hard to talk about Laramie now. To tell you what it is for us. I mean, if you would have asked me before, I would have told you Laramie's a beautiful town.
I have no real interest in prying into a town's unraveling.
You're going to be in a play about my town. You're going to be on stage, and you're going to be pretending like you're us. That's so weird.
He had the most amazing smile, you know? He would walk into a place and just be like...
So what about the night Matthew Shepard was here?
Okay, if you had 100 customers like him, it would be the most perfect bar I've ever been in. He's dressed nice, he's clean-cut, you know, just some people you just know, right?
He wanted to ride home, and I just thought, well, the dude's drunk. Let's take him home.
It was a black truck, a small truck, and them three guys sat in the front, and Matt sat in the middle. And I didn't think nothing of it, you know? I didn't figure them guys were going to be like that.
Matthew Shepard was admitted in critical condition approximately 9:15 p.m. October 7th. Matthew's major injuries upon arrival consisted of hypothermia and a fracture running from behind his head to just in front of the right ear.
After seeing Fred Phelps protest, I decided that somebody
because
needed
they are
to stand
to put
toe-to-toe
Matthew
with this guy and show the
as a poster boy for a gay lifestyle.
At 12:53 a.m., Matthew Shepard died. His family was at his bedside.
After the Matthew thing, we became a town defined by an accident. A crime. We may be able to get rid of that, but it's sure gonna take a while.
And unless you realize this isn't just some random occurrence, the work of some random crazies, you got the blood of Matthew Shepard on your hands.
And we need to own this crime. I feel everyone needs to own it. We are like this.
Right where he was. It blows you away, and I remember thinking to myself that that's the last thing he saw. The last thing Matt Shepard saw on this earth were the sparkling lights.